So we are live, guys. Are we? Yes, can you hear me? Yes, hi Sim24. Ad Astra means aim for the stars. It's basically aiming for the stars. So I just saw that. I thought I'll name this as aim for the stars and it's crack J.
Yes, can you hear me?
Oh yes, I guess it's loud and clear now. Okay, hello guys. So before we start off, I want all of you to maintain social distancing, stay at home and stay safe, wash your hands regularly, and crack JEE here. Okay, so crack JEE with India's largest platform, which is an academy here. Get the plus subscription to access unlimited benefits and exceptional stuff. Okay, so install the app right away. So let me tell you all about the program. First install the app. Okay, there's a lot of fun there. We'll have a lot of quizzes. I'm planning to have quizzes at least 2 times or 3 times a week. At least simple quizzes. Okay, simple quizzes every day I'll keep having. So about me, let me tell you, I am Hola Amigos. Hi friends, I am N. Srikanth. I did my BTech from IIT Kharagpur with an AIR of 385. I've been guiding young minds like you guys for the last 4 odd years. Guide because a lot of students are asking me ranks and all, what I do and all, so what they should do with their ranks and all. I like to help them with what they do rather than pushing them onto one particular engineering or something. Okay. You guys call me human calculator. I'm a Sunrisers fan, and DC is equally marvelous, if not better. I'm a DC fan. So this Ad Astra is the name of the Ad Astra is the name of the course I'm launching. It's just a nice fancy name I put. Ad Astra means aim for the stars. Okay, so basically Ad Astra means aiming for the stars. So let's aim for stars and then crack G by dreaming and planning well. Okay, so this is the new course I'm launching. So what I'm planning is, this is Ad Astra, which is there, which I'll give you theory every day on YouTube along with all some specific important problems. Okay, and every day, or if not every day, every once in 4 days a week, I will have a quiz on the Unacademy app where you can go and like attend the quiz. Okay, so Ad Astra is the name of it. Okay, so yes, I know about that. So this is the course I'm launching, guys. Today we will start off with electric charges and fields. Okay, that is the topic today. Electric charges and fields. This is the first lesson on that. So the topics we are going to discuss today are electric charges, properties of charge, Coulomb's law and problems, and equilibrium and dielectrics. Yeah, dielectrics are very important. If you observe, a lot of questions came from that in JEE, especially the latest year. There was one dielectric problem which was very good. Okay. So we will discuss all of them as we go in today's class, in the first part of this electric charges and fields. Now, one thing about Ad Astra is all the course, the entire course I'm going to teach you is going to be from NCERT book. Okay. It's all going to be from the NCERT based syllabus and also based on the revised syllabus for this 2021. This is for the year 2021. So those guys who are cracking 2021, just go for this. I want you all to share this, subscribe to this channel, and share it everywhere. It's going to be pretty cool. So yeah, let's start off with the first topic, which is electric charges and fields. Okay, hello Ramesh, how are you? Nice, long time. So before we start off, just observe these two things. Okay, what is this? This is carbon, right? And this is the proton and electron. This is looking like a helium. Yes, this is helium and this is carbon. I just drew. Yeah, thank you Ramesh. Nice visual images we are going to put. I am putting all possible GIFs possible just to make it more interesting. So this is how a carbon looks and this is how helium looks. This is a better depiction, of course. But if you observe here, what does it contain? This is the basic of life. Okay, every particle, every matter in the world consists of atoms, right? Everything, atoms are everywhere, right? And inside atom, if you observe, what are we finding here? We're finding electrons which are revolving around it, and then there are neutrons and protons which are bound inside a nucleus. Getting it? So why do you think this is moving in a circle? Best example, best way to understand is why is electron moving around a nucleus in a circle? Because there is some internal force downward. There is some attraction force with which the nucleus is attracting the electron. Okay, electron is getting attracted by nucleus. Similarly, there are many such examples where there is possibility that there is much stronger force than gravitation itself. If you observe, electrons are very less mass, protons also have very less mass. But those are attracted towards each other because the force is not gravitational, there is something very strong. That force is only electric force, electrostatic force, that is what we will be discussing today. So before we go there, we have to understand what a charge is. Okay, charge, electrostatic forces. Yeah, it's okay man, Ramesh. Even I am finally, good to see you here. Okay, come every day. I'll have a class every day from now. Okay, it is the property of matter due to which it produces and experiences electric and magnetic effects. So electric charge is something, it's a property of matter. Okay, it's just like mass. It is like mass. Okay, or volume. Mass or volume, anything. It is like a mass or a volume. It is a property of matter due to which it produces or experiences electric and magnetic fields. Just give me one moment, guys. Yeah. Exactly, that's true. Okay, what is it true for? Okay, fine, let's get back. So, produces electric and magnetic effects. Okay, so the SI unit of charge. Now, charge is a fundamental property. Okay, it's a fundamental property of matter due to which electric and magnetic effects are observed. SI unit of charge is 1 coulomb. Okay, the SI unit is 1 coulomb. And it's another way is also farads. They're also calling one farad, which is 96,500 coulombs. Okay, dimensionally, if you observe, one thing you have to know is that charge is not, it's a property of matter, but it is not a fundamental unit. Okay, charge is not a fundamental unit. It is not fundamental because they thought it was fundamental, but then they found out that current is a much better defined fundamental unit than a charge, because charge can be derived from current, but current can be derived, not be derived from some other factors. Okay, so charge is not the fundamental unit, so it will have certain dimensions. Dimensional formula, you know what dimensional formula is? It is one charge is ampere second, you know, one charge is current into time. Okay, this is the general understanding. Current is rate of flow of charge, that is how you define it, right? So Q is equal to I into T. So the dimensional, it will be 1 ampere and second. The fundamental unit of current is ampere and for time is second, so it will be ampere power 1 second power 1. Second is time power 1. There are other things, right? ML, PA. This M is for mass, L is for length, P is for time, and A is for current, which is amperes. Okay. So using these, we can say the dimensional formula of this is AT. Sometimes you'll also keep writing M also, no? So you can write M power 0, L power 0, T power 1, A power 1. This also you can write. Got it? So this is the dimensional formula. It is I into T. Remember, charge is a fundamental property, but you cannot measure it. Okay, it is not measured in a fundamental unit. Just I'll explain. Volume, your whole body has volume. Now, it is a property of your body, but then it is not a fundamental volume. Volume is not a fundamental quantity. It is derived. Its dimensional formula is L power 3. Getting it? Same way, charge is also a fundamental property, but it is not a fundamental unit. Know the difference. Don't get confused saying everything which is property of body will should have its own dimension. Aisa nahi hai. Got it? So this way you can adjust it and have fun. So you have to understand charge is current into time. You know this from school. If you don't know, you can remember this. I current is the rate of flow of charge into time will give the total charge. Okay. Next, then we'll see into the basic properties of charge. There are two kinds of charges. Okay, one is positive charge and one is negative charge. So basically, how these positive charge and negative charge got defined? Let me tell you, this is a pure accident. One guy was flying a kite. One guy called Benjamin Franklin, I guess. Yeah, Benjamin Franklin only. He liked flying kites. So one day current was gone. He just put one extra. He put his key and he started flying kite so that it will balance well. And then suddenly what happened? There was a lightning which struck the kite and he got current shock. So that is when he realized that charge is flowing from somewhere, from the top. He was able to feel that charge hit him. He was flying a kite and he could feel the charge, which means the charge is flowing. That is how we realize that there are different kinds of charge. Something is moving from there to here. So there are different kinds of motions of charge also. So that from there he came up with this, that there are two kinds of charges, and he named one of them positive and the other negative. This is purely accident. So this he named like the charge of an proton is one positive charge and electron is negative. So he decided in an atom, which we just saw, in an atom, let's draw an atom here. An atom is a nuclei and electron which is moving like this. Electron is moving in circular path, the nucleus. So inside nucleus there is proton. So what he decided is that this proton which is inside the nucleus, as we discussed, is positive charge. And electron which is rotating due to the extra field we discussed is having negative charge. So electron is negative and proton is positive. Okay. So one more thing you have to understand, that in a how do you define a matter? Matter is a collection of atoms, right? So if atoms start moving from one side to another side, it is actually matter movement, no? So if you want to say charge is transferring or charge movement is not actual electron, is not actual atom moving. So this proton which is inside a matter, which is inside a material already, should be inside only. What can move out then? Something which is rotating around it and which is loose. What can that be? It is electrons, right? So the actual negative charge means there is more electrons in the substance, and positive charge means there are less electrons in the substance. These electrons which are revolving around an atom, let's call this a nucleus. There will be electrons revolving around it in different orbitals, you know, right? So these electrons which are rounding along, these can easily go out. Just like some earth is rotating around sun, someone gives extra energy to it, it will go out. No, escape velocity and all can also be possible here. Similarly, someone blows your hair like this, the atoms on the outermost part of the skin, the electrons will blow out. The protons will not, the nucleus will stay here only because the entire matter is here. But electrons which have negligible mass and are loosely packed, they will go out. So from this you can say that electrons will actually move out. Electrons movement causes charge. Getting it? Electron movement causes charge. Now if electrons are less, it means protons are more, and you will mean it is positive charge. Getting it? If electrons are more, there will be less protons, more electrons. So total charge will be dominated by electrons, which is negative charge. So that is it. So this is a little small funny example, just to cheer up you guys. Someone will say, I lost an electron. So are you positive? Sound better in your head if you read it yourself. I'm bad at jokes. You all know it. So yeah. So when you lose an electron, you will have positive charge. When you gain an electron, you will have negative charge. Okay. This is the most basic fundamental thing about charges. You lose electrons, you're positive. You gain electrons, you are negative. So that is the main concept behind it. Okay. Okay, so one more very important thing which all of you guys already know is that like charges repel and unlike charges attract. This everyone knows. Lot of you use it in different contexts also. So this is very commonly known everywhere. Anything you want to say, feel free to comment in the chat section. Okay, so this is the main thing. Like charges repel and unlike charges attract. You take two charges and leave them like this. These both charges will repel. Okay, and these both charges will attract. This is pulled like this. This is pulled. Getting it? Your negative orange will be in isolation. Nice one, man. Yeah, so basically transfer of your negative of corona, which means so you have more corona electrons. Huh? That is not the case, but yeah, okay. Okay, so like charges repel and opposite charges attract. Okay, so this is the major thing you have to understand now. Now let's get back to specific properties of charge. We'll understand some properties as we go. Just keep going, understanding what it is. I'll underline some points which are important. Charge is a scalar quantity. Charge is a scalar quantity, which means, like we just discussed, electrons will have positive charge, negative charge. Electrons are negative charge. Protons are positive charge. What is the direction to electrons negative charge? If you are negative or positive, you won't have any direction. No. How do you define, if the only way of defining it is plus or minus? Simple, you understand it this way. The marks you get in IIT JEE exam, okay, are they vector or scalar? Your marks don't have a direction. You should have a direction because you should study with the direction, but then your marks won't have direction. No, same way charge is also like your marks. It will be positive sometimes in RNA exams like that. If that tough, it will be negative. Okay, like this IIT JEE exam, if you find it tough, then you'll get negative. Okay, that way only charge is scalar. It has no direction. It is only what? Charge is only the measure of excess or deficiency of electrons. Charge is basically the measure of extra. Any extra electrons which are there or less electrons is there, how many are there? It's like census. Okay. Everyone will come, every time they'll ask how many people are more or less, how many in the house, just like that only. Charge also, it is the measure of number of extra electrons or deficiency of electrons. Okay. So next, charge is invariant, which means that body, the charge is independent of frame of reference. Suppose, so generally you know this, right? If the mass of the body will change with increasing speed, if the speed becomes comparable to rate, the mass will become the rest mass into root over 1 minus V naught square by C square. Something like this. So I don't think this is there. This is what you will get. Okay, this is generally the mass in motion. So as the body's mass keep, velocity keeps increasing, its ideal mass will keep increasing. Okay, this you learn in nuclear physics. Okay, there's nothing, no need to remember this formula. Don't remember many formulas, guys, just understand the logic and go with the flow. Okay, that is what I want you guys to do. Go with the flow. We'll have quiz every day, simple quizzes and tough problems also. I am planning to that I'll cover around the entire topic, I will at least cover 5 to 10 problems every day of HC Verma. Okay, that is my main motto. We will have another, after this class, we will have one extra session where we will discuss about it. Okay, it is a measure of excess electrons, that is it. So, now mass, as it becomes very fast moving, its effective mass will keep increasing using this formula. Okay, it is increasing, that's all you have to understand. But charge is not like that. Okay, charge is independent of frame of reference. Like if the charge is accelerating, the value of the charge will not change. If the charge is at rest, the value of charge will not change. Even if it's moving with very fast speed also, the charge will not change. Got it? Charge is something which is fixed to the matter. It is transferable. One more thing is, it is transferable. All of you know it. I've seen there are live examples of it happening. Whenever you touch something, you feel that shock. When you rub a glass rod with wool, or woolen cloth or some silk cloth, you put the glass rod, close your hand will start getting the goosebumps, the hair rising thing. So all these examples are examples that charge can be transferred. Okay. If a charged body comes in contact with another, then charge gets distributed, comes in contact or vicinity. It's not just contact, it is or vicinity. It's not just touching. Even if it comes close, there will be transfer of charges. Okay. So this kind of static charge is the excess. So transfer of the static charge is only called as static electricity. Getting it? The transfer of static charge is called static electricity. It is the excess or deficiency of electrons on a body which gets transferred. That charge means, the static charge means the excess or deficiency of electrons on a body. Understood? It is excess or deficiency. And the flow of charge is called static electricity. Getting it? Like in the first case, this boy here is rubbing it. So there is exchange of electrons, as a result of which this is rising up, because this gets charged and this also gets charged. The balloon gets a particular charge and the hair also gets another particular charge. And in this case, this man is getting electrocuted. How is he getting electric shocked? Because there is excess charge in the surroundings, excess electrons in the surroundings or within him. There is flow of excess electrons from surroundings to him or vice versa. We don't know exactly. There is electrons only. Electrons are flowing from outside to his body. That is why he gets electric shock. Got it. Similarly, when you touch a metal doorknob after the walking on a rubber cloth or putting your hand through rubber, you will feel that electric tinge. Okay. All those things are statics. Okay. Static electricity. Let's define what static electricity is now. Okay, static electricity, how does it occur and all? Static electricity occurs when an object obtains a net amount of positive or negative charge, creating an imbalance that wants to be returned to equilibrium. So generally what happens is every body should want to have equal positive and negative charges, okay? Because that is how balance is restored. A body will be neutral. We'll understand what neutral is. So everywhere there is charge, no? As we discussed till now, everywhere there is charge. Okay. Just give me one moment. Okay, so it's okay. Let's leave it here. So keep it. Every body has charge, right? Every body on the surface will have atoms, and atoms have positive charge and negative charge. Both are there. But how are we able to not feel that attraction and all between protons of, how can I also have atoms? Even this laptop through to which I'm talking to you has atoms. You're watching on a phone. Phone has atoms. You have atoms. Why are they all not attracting or repulsing each other? Why is not phone sticking to you? It is because of this wonderful concept called neutral. Neutral means, so as we discussed, excess of electrons is positive charge and less of electrons is negative charge. If electrons and protons are equal, then the body is said to be in neutral condition. Understood? If the total electrons and protons in a body are equal, it's said to be neutral condition. Okay. So then what is the main thing of this is, neutral means it is in a more balanced state. Everywhere when there are more electrons, they'll try to go to a place which is less electrons. And less electrons will try to move to a place which has more electrons. Getting the point? That is how it generally works. But neutral in this case, this is the ultimate balance that it wants to reach. Everyone wants to reach that balanced, peaceful state. That peaceful state, everything will be in equilibrium. Equilibrium, peaceful state, and you are neutral. So static electricity, what happens is when there is too much electrons on one side and less electrons on the other side, the excess electrons transfer through the static. It is temporarily there. It's not there. It's not currently moving. It's not current moving electricity. It's static, it's stuck inside a body. Okay, and the moment you touch it with some other body, there is sudden transfer of electrons, which is what you feel as shock, electric shock. Getting it? It is the imbalance that wants to be returned to equilibrium. Excess electrons will cause imbalance, or excess protons will cause imbalance. That will only return to equilibrium. Understood? So next, the next thing about static electricity and charge is the induction. From this you can understand that charge is transferring from one place to another place, right? From this clearly you can see that when you feel the static electricity with you, or like in this boy's case here, or in the guy's poor umbrella guy there who got electrocuted. So those kind of examples, if you see that charge is actually transferring through some medium. So we can clearly see from this that charges can be transferred. So now we'll understand about how ancient people used to transfer charges, or what is like the general way charges are transferred without any extra effort. If you want to just transfer charge through the equipments you have, there are three kinds majorly. Okay, one is charging by friction. This is the wonderful GIF I found on YouTube. Some kick-ass guy, thanks to them, I've put this GIF. Okay, so this will clearly explain. Just see this GIF. I'm not going to talk anything. And rod is rubbed with silk cloth. All we know is cloth will acquire negative charge and rod will acquire positive charge. So this is what happens. You observe that it took the charge, negative charge, and because this took more negative charges, the rod became positive. Observe again. This one took negative charges. There are more electrons here. More electrons. So this is now negatively charged. This acquires positive. This electron is going there, and that electron is coming here. Getting it? So this is the display. This is the awesome GIF we have here. Yes, got it. So that is the first thing. So it is by friction. Generally on the outermost layers, whatever wherever there are free electrons, there will be outermost layer. So what I want to say, it's all nuclear. Okay, suppose outermost layer has loose electrons, like on a glass rod there are loose electrons on the outside. Okay, what will happen is the silk will just rub it off along it. Outer electrons will get just rubbed through, and this part will get positive, that part will get negative. Actually, this is also one of the reasons for friction to happen. These both are like opposite, equal and opposite reactions. These, the upper surface takes off the electrons from the lower surface. There is transfer of outermost electrons. As a result of which, the upper part gets negative charge, lower part gets little positive charge, and they both start attracting each other. This is the basic fundamental behind interlocking. This is also another fundamental behind the reason of friction. Friction interlocking is what you know, no? The interlocking is actually due to charging by friction. Got it? So this is one very important thing you can, you've never thought of, but if you realize it, you'll get it, okay? So when they are neutral, huh? So electrons, so let me tell you, suppose there is a perfectly balanced crown, okay? It's like a crown, a human, the all atoms and all are not smooth, okay? Eventually they'll be like this. Not looking like a crown. So let's call it something like this. This is some crown there is, okay? Suppose some fast body is going like this and hitting it. So what will happen? It will take off this finger, kachak, kachak, it cut off the whole thing, right? So what will you be left with? This part. And these parts are already in this. You're able to understand in microscopic level, that is how it just swipes through. Two surfaces are like this, they'll just swipe through each other. Someone is going to take the other. Getting it? So loosely packed electrons, wherever they are possible, those electrons will just hit, they'll get hit by the upper body and they'll just be dragged off. Getting it? So you need to have loose electrons. Where will you find loose electrons? When the electron affinity is very less. No, chemistry. You know chemistry better than I do. If the electron affinity is more, then electrons, loose electrons will not be there. If electron affinity is less, then will be loose electrons. No, so that is how it is. One body has more electron affinity, one body has less electron affinity. Suppose one material. You're rubbing both of them. Zupac. Electron attracting body will just attract all the these electrons, which is what is happening here. Understood? So this is the got your doubt, SIM 24? Yes, it's clear, right? Okay, now charging by contact. So charging by contact means, suppose there is one body which has just neutral and one body which is positive charge. Let's take one body which is positive charge, like here in this exam, and one body which is negative charge, just like it showed here. Okay, so what happens, wherever there is excess negative charge, that charge will get distributed to the other body also. Getting it? So when the bodies are in contact, generally there are more, so it's like gates opening. Okay, this side there are a lot of people, on this rod there are a lot of people. Call it like two positive rod and one negative rod. Okay, in negative rod, there are a lot of people, a lot of electrons, excess electrons, they are getting crowded. They are getting one over the other. The moment you touch these both, the gates open. And full electrons, now they are in contact. Now electrons are free to move along conducting surfaces. So if the surfaces are conducting surfaces, electrons will freely move. It's open gate has happened and everything is going to the other side. And eventually, when will it balance? When there are equal amounts of negatives on both sides. Are you able to understand? Perfect, right? Okay, very good. So yes, now the third thing is charging by induction. This is a very cool thing. That is why I didn't give this thing for it. So these both are straightforward. Now charging by induction is a little tricky way. Okay, so let's see this step by step. First, a charging body which has only positive charge, let's say, okay, is only positive charge is being brought close to a chargeless pair. Initially brought in an uncharged body. Okay, there is no charge on this body initially. It is neutral. Okay, it is neutral. And then there are some positive charged body which is coming here. Now, what do we know? Negative, the unlike charges attract and like charges repel. So, when this positive charge is coming here, what will happen? The entire electrons from this side will come off to this side. Like when a fashion show is happening, all the guys will come to the fashion show. Watch. Same way. Lot of positive charges are here. All negative charges will get attracted to this. And then all the positive charges will go to the other side. Okay. So this is generally, so this is out. Now one side is full of negative charge. The other side has only protons. All the electrons on the right side have gone to the left side already. All these electrons left them and went to the left side. So now what will happen? This side, suppose you ground. You are grounding this. Grounding means what happens? Grounding or earthing? or earthing is a very fantastic phenomenon. Now, what do we know about earth? Like, you know, all these circuits, you know, any circuit, your electric circuit at your house, you will have grounding. You will have that there's an earth wire and all, right? There will be an earth wire there. So how do you get this earth wire? Now, what does that do? Basically, what it does, it neutralizes the system whenever it is connected. Okay. So like in this case, there is positive charge here and it is connected to the earth. Earth generally is neutral. In any case, it's neutral. Even if you give it 100 coulombs charge, it will still remain neutral. If you take in 100 coulombs charge from it also, it will remain neutral. So earth is generally a universal neutral. It is always neutral. So what will happen now? This side has positive charge, which means this has less electrons. Earth has enough electrons in it to just give electrons if they are feeling less. Yeah, they're infinite electrons. So this is like a small bucket and this is ocean. You want water in the bucket. You're going to the bucket and the ocean and you're taking some water, because you dip the bucket in water, in ocean, water will fill in. That is what happens. You touch this with the ground, there will be positive charge which is filling in on this side. But ocean has enough water. Same way, earth will have enough negative charge. As a result of which, this side, the negative charges will become neutral. Okay, and this side, positive charges will become neutral. And this side, the negative charges will remain. Now you remove the body of Achanak. On the right side, now every electron is happy. Every proton is happy with its electron. Now whatever extra electrons which left home before, now when they come back home, there is no place. So entirely what will happen? This whole thing will now become negatively charged. Okay, this is magical because of Earth. What it is that you have a positive charged body. With that, if you connect it to some other body, you will think generally you will only get positive charge, because this is positive, you can give some positive. Aisa nahi hai. You have a positive body, you can ground the other body and create new negative charges also. Getting it? This is the magic of it. When you have a positive charge, you can create both kinds of charge. By conduction, like in the previous case, by conduction, if you check, whatever side is having more positive charge, it will distribute the extra. Whichever side is having less electrons, will take, borrow some electrons from the other side, eventually both will become positive, or that can happen. Okay, suppose there is one plus charge and one neutral. If you connect both of them, both will eventually have little plus. Because this has less electrons, this will give little electrons to balance everywhere. The whole universe is a balancing act, guys. The whole universe is a balancing act. Everywhere it wants balance, carry balance. Everywhere, entire world wants balance. Even charges, right from the basic fundamental charges to the entire universe and across the countries, equality, all of these are to bring balance. So remember this word, this is what the world needs. Similarly, when something has more positive, other is neutral, it will balance out. Little depends on the materials, but little balancing will. So induction is one way of reversing it. Like you can reverse charge, you can opposite charge it using the ground. Got it? So this is also another wonderful method to create this. So what here we can do multiple, like there are two neutral charges. This is next level of induction. Okay, there are two neutral metal balls connected to each other. Now one side you bring one positive charge. Now what will happen? Now the entire negative charges will come to this side, the positive charges will remain here. Getting it? And now you remove the contact between both of them. You are just breaking it. Break up. Then what happens? The negative charges which are this side will get stuck this side, because they cannot charge, come through air. They are stuck on the left side, and similarly the right side positive charges are stuck. As a result, now if you put them far enough, you will have two balls which are initially uncharged. Just with one charge, you made two different kinds of charge. See, these kind of experiments are, from these experiments only, they derive that there are two kinds of charges available by induction, by all these fundamental methods. Got it? But let me talk about conduction and induction now, by transfer, through actual transfer and induction. Okay. Now what you have to understand is, either by conduction or by induction, first we'll do by conduction, by actual contact. What can we say if there is a one charge given? Now, the entire charge cannot go off to the other side. No, there won't be no full transfer of charge. This is one obvious thing. Suppose you have 100 rupees, that case having 0 rupees, you have 100 electrons, let's say. That guy has 0 electrons. You won't give all your 100 electrons to him and then you won't start asking him, no? You will give 50 to him, 50 to yourself, or 60 to you, 40 to him, something like that you will do. But you won't give off 100, you cannot give more than 100. No, full or greater. Obvious, no? So you cannot have 1 coulomb charge with you and you cannot do this and the other side will become plus 2 coulombs. You cannot do that. By induction, you can only create equal or less. You cannot full transfer by conduction. Getting it? So you have 1 coulomb charge, some 0 coulomb charge. Suddenly you touch it. This will not become plus 10. This will not become minus and all. Getting it? Just balancing. The entire universe wants balance. That is what even induction, conduction, everything is about balance. Getting it? So no full transfer. In convection also, by induction you can create negative charges also. By induction you can create negative type charges. By conduction you will create only like charges. Like charges with neutral. When you connect a neutral body with this body, you will have only same. You have a positive charge and you are touching a neutral body, you will get two positives. Half or little less. You won't have one positive, one negative. But by induction, if you have a positive body, you can create a negative body by induction and grounding. Understood? So this is the key factor for induction and conduction. The main differences are these. In both cases, it won't be possible that whatever electrons are here, more electrons will not get affected. That is always the case. Got it? Now we'll discuss some other continuation of basic properties of charge. Now we understood it transfers through electrons only and how it transfers through different methods. We've seen all the GIFs also, interesting movements. Now let's look into the basic properties of charge. Okay, charge is always associated with mass. This is one key place where mass beats charge. Everywhere else, I feel that mass is left over, bechara. Mass is always less, is weaker than charge everywhere. I feel bad for mass. Okay, but then the whole concept is, hi Ashish Reddy. Hello man, good to see you all here. Yes, so charges are associated with mass, but not the other way around. This is the major trump card of mass. Mass is a must. It's a prerequisite type. Like you have to pass intermediate to qualify JEE, to crack JEE and go into IIT, no? Same way here also, if you have mass only, you will have charge. Okay, if you don't have mass, there is no charge, no question of it. Okay. Good man, good. So many of you are here from class. Very nice to see you all. Tell everyone around, tell the entire college. Okay, I want you guys to. I know man, J2, everyone. Like three of you are from J2 only. Okay, so what I want you is, I want you to tell all the others also that I am teaching here, I am starting this course, we'll have lots of problems also. So make sure you tell them. Saket is also here. Yeah, see, even he is now. So wow man, this is full wonderful. Tell everyone guys, make it viral. Let's all sit and chat here. In the app though it is even more fun. So I want you guys to come to the app also today in the next class. I will have the app class from 10 to 10:30 to 11:30, 12. Okay. So we'll have quiz there. I'm putting a quiz there. Yes, Ramesh, you are not. What are you first in? Okay, whatever it is, tell everyone, guys. Let's have an interaction here. Because the interaction there is live, I can tell you. Now, I think this chat happened 40 seconds or 50 seconds ago. Wow, nice. Harish, nice man, awesome, great. So yeah, tell everyone that I'm here. We'll have fun in the app, in Unacademy app. Okay, so get there. We'll discuss there. Here there's a 50-second delay, so I am unable to give live discussion here. But yeah, let's go for it. Charge is always associated with mass, which is mass is compulsory. Okay, that is why you say no, conservation of mass and all is the first thing which comes to mind before charge also. Mass. Here Baba. Charge definitely contains mass, but not the other way around. Okay. App name is Unacademy. Unacademy Learners app. Okay, this is the app. Install it. 10:30 go and you will find me there. Just type my name, N. Srikanth. Type my name N Srikant and you will find me there. You have some note, you have to follow me, like on Instagram you have to follow, so just follow me there and then you'll get all the classes. Okay. So that is it. Go, we'll have it at 10:30 today. Before that, let's finish this. Okay, we're already going very slow. We have to go a little fast because I know this time it's been a little less. No, the time is less, so we'll go a little fast. Presence of charge indicates presence of mass, while it's not the other way around. Okay, yeah. In charging, the mass of the body changes. So from this only you can understand electrons have mass. Okay, electrons have mass. What is the mass of electron? It's around 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kgs. Very less, but it has mass. So when a negative charged body has more electrons and it's touched with positive charged body. Suppose a negative body is touched with a positive body, what will happen? Electrons are flowing like this, which means this side is having more mass now, this side will have less mass now. So that is how charge is transferred. Getting it? When a body is given positive charge, its mass reduces. Very straightforward. Now this is something I've designed it myself. I'm making some questions on the go, very simple questions. I want you guys to mark the right answer. I'll give you 2 minutes. Okay. Just come and stay here and I want you guys to answer this. A glass rod was initially weighed 1 kg. When a glass rod is rubbed with silk, the weight of the rod now will be. I am giving you 1 minute, guys. 8:47 is the time. I want you guys to type the answer. When glass rod is rubbed on silk, what will happen? Yes, I got an answer. Sim24, fast as usual. Good one, Sim. What about the others? Ramesh? Saket? Karthik? Yes, correct. That is right, guys. So, like this only, you'll have interaction in the quiz also in the app, but it is very fast. It's spontaneous. So, be there, okay? So, obviously, now a rod is rubbed with silk. What happens? Rod will get positive charge and the silk will get negative charge, right? Which means silk will have more electrons now. It took off electrons from the rod, as a result of which the rod's mass will be less than 1 kg. Getting it? Like we discussed here, silk will take electrons from the rod, which means rod is losing electrons. Each electron will have 9.1 to 10 power minus 31 kgs. So it will lose, but it's much less. It's very little, the mass, but it's still less only. So if it is 1 kg now, it will be 0.9999 some 30 times and some 2 kg. Something like this it will be. Okay, so that is how it is. Now we'll go to the next one. It's a very basic question. Now we'll go to the next. From here only we'll have more problem solving. Okay, one thing we know, charge is quantized. What is it? It is quantized. What is the meaning of quantized? You have to understand the word. You cannot by heart this word, because this will be used everywhere. Quantum of charge, all these things. You'll have quantum of this thing, angular momentum and all, they're in packets. All this you'll have. One quantum of energy you'll have. So all those means, quantized means it exists only in numbers. Let me explain. So electrons are like chocolates. Okay, charge is like chocolate. The more you can count the number, it's like gems also, you can say. Each charge is like gem. It is one, there will be number of gems. Okay, you cannot say I had 1 kg of gems and all, right? So the gems are quantized. What about milk or water? You will never say I had 2.1 grams of water. Okay, you will always say I had a glass of water. That is the general thing. No? You cannot measure in glasses of water. It's the reverse way. Let me put it. How do you receive milk? Drinking me. How do you receive milk in packets? Cool drink in bottles. Cool drink in bottles. Armrest in that wonderful ampana and all in that nice smooth tetra packs. Okay, now you buy in bottles or packets. You will never buy in glasses or you will never buy in terms of number of milk atoms. You will never go to a milk person and say, bhaiya, I want 6.023 into 10 power 23 molecules of milk. You won't say that, no. So that is what is the quantization. Okay, you will buy packets of milk. You will buy packets of milk. You won't buy glasses or drops of milk and all. Same way, electron charge also will be in packets. Okay, charge is found in packets. Like, let me explain. Your length, suppose some charged length of a body is there. What is the lowest amount of length you have ever imagined? It will be minus 10 power minus 40 meters. Something even less than that is possible. 10 power minus 50 meters. You can imagine, no, that you keep writing 10 power minus 60, 10 power minus 70. Like atom, in that atom, atom and what is that? In that Ant-Man, he becomes so small, he will go into some other dimension and all. He will become 10 power minus 50. Even smaller, he will become 10 power minus 60 meters like that. Okay, it will become smaller and smaller and smaller. But charge does not do that. Okay, charge is not like Ant-Man. It will compress to a minimal extent. Only at that minimal extent, it will be available in packets of charge. Like one charge, it will have units of charge. There are units of charge, which means from beyond this, below this, there is no possible free charge which is available. Okay, that charge is a charge of the basic element of life, which is atom. Atom, what all charges are there? We discussed electrons and protons. And electrons are the ones which are moving. So by that only we can understand that electron is the lowest charge which is available freely. Everything else, if there is possible lower values than electrons, those do not exist in free state. Okay, there are quarks and leptons and all, they are there. Quarks and all, they will have charges in plus or minus 2 by 3 into charge of electron. Like this they will have. So inside an electron, inside a proton, what happens we don't know yet. That is what you guys have to figure out. But these quarks and leptons, how do they stay inside protons stably, but outside when they come, they cannot exist in real life. They'll end up becoming electrons only. Okay. They don't exist in free state. Why this happens? You have to figure it out. Okay. Study well. I want you all to study well and figure it out. But what you know is that charges only exist in terms of electrons. Anything below charge of electron, it is not possible in real life. Okay. So, from this, what do we know? Charge of electron will be opposite of charge of proton. Okay. To make anything neutral, one thing we know, if everything is in packets, one positive packet is there, means corresponding negative packet should be same. No, only then you'll have neutral balance. Remember, the whole universe wants balance. So, if the whole universe wants balance, what you should do is you should hit the like button right away. After that, you have to understand that when there is negative, there should be equal amount of positive. And there is one negative packet, there will be equal amount of positive packet. Got it? So, charge of proton will be exactly opposite of charge of one electron. These both are basics of charge. Okay. And the value will be equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. Yes. Hi, Naveen. Hello, man. Lot of you guys. It's very exciting to see you. So, understand this. Are you getting it? So, I'm starting a new class. So, just come every day. We'll have classes on everything. Mostly HCFM problems and all we'll have. Yes, charge of proton is minus charge of an electron, which is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Getting it? This is the charge of one electron or one proton. So, okay. Now you have to understand one more thing. One coulomb and one proton. One electron, one proton, one coulomb. They are so far apart, right? They are so far apart. How many? I'll just ask you a simple question first. Example. Number of protons in one coulomb. Let's see. So, one thing we know now is protons charge is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. And what is the charge of an electron? It is minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. Just because Benjamin Franklin called it negative. We called it some alpha beta. Charge would have been alpha charges and negative beta charges. Now they are positive negative. But generally positive negative is because it is scalar. It does not have direction and it's easy to calculate. Symmetry will be there if you have positive and negative. So that is totally understandable. Yeah. So electrons will have minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. And protons will have plus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 9. Remember this. 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. You can also write this as 8 by 5 into 10 to the power minus 19. This way you can remember it. You can also write this as 10 by 2.5 square into 10 to the power minus 19. Why I am writing this is whenever you find calculations, remember you can convert into something like this. Okay. This way if you convert, you can solve problems very easily. Straightforward ho jayega calculations. So the first thing we'll do is find the number of protons in one coulomb. Let's say the like this only, the q will be equal to number of electrons into e. Q will be equal to n into e. Okay, what is the value of q now? Q is 1 coulomb. It will be equal to number into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 9. So from this, what will I get? N will be 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Now you understood why I gave this. So this is inverse of 1.6. So I'll write this as 5 pi 8 into 10 to the power 19. Is 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 protons. So these many protons, 10 power 18, these many protons should be more than electrons. Getting it? They should be these many number of protons and extra. These many number of protons extra is called 1 coulomb. That is a huge number, no? Many protons extra will be a 1 coulomb charge. Very huge. So eventually this quantum of charge, this quantization will become, it will become very fluid, like 1.1 coulomb and 1.0001 coulomb also will be existing. Okay, it's not like only after 1, 2 will be there like that. It's not the case. But because that actually the basic packet is so small, it's like how do you say, rice basta, each rice is, imagine, one quanta of charge. Okay, the whole basta, if you throw it like sand, man, forget rice basta. Okay, sand, if you jump in sand and you jump, dive catches in sand, you can happily move around in sand. You will feel sand is smooth only, no? It is not very rough. Beach sand especially, it's very smooth, fine beach sand. Okay, so from there, if you jump there and all, you will feel it smooth, it is very continuous, it is very it feels like that. But then if you observe closely, each is having a packet. Every single sand molecule will be a packet of charge like that. Are you able to understand? Better examples. Yeah, another thing is you're sitting in the, how many of you are sitting in beanbag right now? You can observe in beanbag only. Inside there are all small quantas, but eventually if the entire thing is together, you'll feel it is a solid, easily flowing body. Getting it? Okay, enough of examples. Now, yes. Now for the question, which of the following does not exist as a free charge? Thing does not exist. I'll give the options. One is 8 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. B is 4 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. C is 0.8 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. And D is, let's call it 0.8. And D is 5 into 10 to the power minus 19. Or we'll just call. Fine, let's leave it here. So anyone who is try to take a guess, guys, I'll give you a minute here. Think about it. What or how many of these do not exist as a free charge? Yes, come on, guys. I need answers. So yes, none of you have got the answer. So let me explain it to you. Go slow, yaar, tum log. Okay. So charge should exist as a multiple of 1.6 into 10 to the power minus to n should be equal to the charge. Now if you substitute in the A case, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into n is equal to 8 into 10 to the power minus 19. From this you get n is equal to how much? 5. Right, n is equal to 5, which is pretty cool. It's correct. So this exists. Now what about B? 4 into 10 to the power minus 19. 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into n is equal to 4 into 10 to the power minus 19. N kitna hua? 4 by 1.6, which is 2.5. So can this exist as a part, as a multiple of 2.5? Of course no, right? So this is also right answer. Getting it? This is not possible. So this is one of the correct answers. Similarly, 0.8 is half of this. Can it exist in halves? No, even this is correct. And it's pi into 10 power minus 19. What is pi? It is an irrational number. You know this, right? Pi is an irrational number. So from this, we can see even this does not exist. So these three, B, C, D do not exist as free charges. Free charges means at any particular instant of my one instant of life in the universe, there can be charges of any type available because the universe is so huge. The macroscopic level, it's so huge. Everywhere inside, there will be electrons. Everywhere inside, somewhere it could have happened. Okay. But it does not exist in free state. Okay. Does not exist in free state. Like normally, Goku is like that only. But he has so much energy, Dragon Ball, he does that Kamehameha and all. It is very strong, but then he does not do it every time. In a while, it is available like that here and there, but in free is not like that. Same way here also. In free charges, only multiples are present. In the other time, the non-multiples of quanta of charge, which is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. This is the number you have to keep remembering. It is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. The basic unit of charge. 1 coulomb is SI unit, and this is the basic unit, it's the minimum. That's about it. Next, there's one more interesting question. As we saw the helium diagram, number of helium atoms which makes 4 microcoulombs is given by, so I'll write it myself here, it is x into 10 to the power 12. Okay, the value of x is, we have to find this numerical type question, the number of helium atoms which make 4 microcoulombs. Helium atoms, nahi, this is ions, okay, this will be ions. So now what is helium ion's charge B? Helium has 2 electrons, right? Helium has 2 electrons. So when helium ions happen, ions means the 2 electrons are gone now. So each helium will have how much charge? 2 plus charge, right? Which means one helium atom, the charge is, you will be 2 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Understood? Each positive charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Since a helium atom has 2 helium ion, we'll make it 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs is the charge of one atom. So now 4 microcoulombs, it's such a small number, right? 4 microcoulombs feels so less. We have to check integral multiples now. Exactly, that's all. The previous question. But you have to do it fast, Sim. I know there's a lot of delay, but then be faster than this. Okay, let's finish this first. This is value of one charge. Okay, so there are n such charges. N into 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 19 will be equal to 4 micro. What is the value of micro? 10 power minus 6 coulomb. What is the value of n now? 4 by 3.2 into 10 to the power 13, which is 1.25 into 10 to the power 13, or it is 12.5 into 10 to the power. So numerical type question, what is the answer you have to type? X is 12.50. Getting it? The answer is 12.50. Great job, guys. Okay, now calculate the mass of the above charge. What is the mass of one proton or one neutron? Helium 2 plus contains 4 protons, right? Four protons, need 2 protons and 2 neutrons. Protons and two. And what is the mass of each of them? We'll take approximately 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilo. No, something along this only it will be. Something along this number. Okay. So each of them has this much. So one molecule of helium plus one molecule, one atom of helium 2 plus one ion will have how much? This is a bonus question, by the way. They're just having bonus question. So we'll have 4 into 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 27, which is 6.8 to 10 to the power minus 27 kgs. The number of molecules we have here, so what is the total mass we'll have? For a small charge also, the total mass will be 6.8 into 10 to the power minus 27 multiplied by the number of electrons. 12.5 into 10 power 12. From this we get 6.8 into 12.5 is 85. 85 into 10 to the power minus 15 kilo. So it will be very small, I agree. Each charge, when the charge is itself so small, the value will also be very less, but you have to understand that there is mass. Okay. And it is also very less if you observe. That way you can understand how much charge and how much mass. Pure charge will be so, the charge due to electrostatic nature will be so high compared to the gravitational force. Got it. We'll do that problem also in. As we go. Okay, another property is charge is conserved. Okay, this is a very important point. You have to observe that in an isolated system, which means in a closed system, the total charge does not change with time. What do you understand? That a total charge, although there is a system containing some 5 coulombs of charge, you break that system isolated, you don't take any charge in or out from there. Isolated means it is a closed, it's closed to the outside, charge wise. Someone from outside is hitting it on the inside through some other special material which is not giving charge. In that case, what will happen? Suppose it's breaking into 2-3 pieces. Each one will have some random charges. But what do we know is the total charge will not change. Each piece can have different charge. Like if 5 coulomb charge breaks into 5 pieces, each piece can have 1 coulomb charge. But the total will always be 5. Suppose there is 2, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 0 are there. Fifth part will have minus 1 because sum should always be equal to 5 coulombs. Getting it? So the sum of all the charges in a system will remain same if it is not connected with any external charge. If an external charge is being connected to this, then those both together will be a system. Getting it? Isolated system is a system where the total charge or mass of both of them together will not change. Okay. Like two bodies are colliding in an isolated system. The total mass of the system will not change. Same way charge also will not change. Getting it? So one thing you can understand, when collision or something, when interaction happens in an isolated system, you can understand, you can make sure that mass will not change. If mass is not changing, you know charge will not change, right? Because charge is equivalent of mass. We just discussed that. So this way you can link both of them. Hi Hemant, World of Gaming, very nice, welcome. Okay, thank you. Next, so in an isolated, you're getting the point, right? When mass is constant in a closed system, charge will also remain constant. Charge can neither be created nor destroyed. This is mass ka definition also. Mass can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be converted from one form to the other form. Similarly, charge can neither be created nor destroyed. Conservation of charge will hold good in all reactions. Chemical reactions, nuclear reactions, everywhere. So this is where charge will trump mass, okay? Mass can get converted into energies. Yet charge will not get converted to energy also. No energy for charge, it is remaining same. That's all, nothing will change about it. Got it? The charge can neither be created nor destroyed. That is the thing you've been studying since 8th class, 9th class, 10th class, 11th class, even in 12th class. It's very important to understand balance and conservation. Okay, yeah. Next. So next, for a comprehensive multiple choice, this is all for JEE only. Okay, this is these kind of questions I'll keep putting in here and there. I want you guys to use your presence of mind and solve this. Okay, I'll be giving these kind of questions across. Okay, any simple problem, until and unless the concept is very theoretical, I will make them into questions like this. Okay, so this is the new thing I'm in starting. Two charges of minus 1 coulomb and 5 coulomb are placed in an isolated box and 5 joules of energy is given to the system by shaking it. Someone is giving energy to it by shaking it. Internal energy bad gaya. As a result, both the charges turned positive. Wow. No external charge was added to the system. Okay. Which of the following have been recorded in this experiment? The total mass of the system increases. Will it increase? You are giving energy to it. The internal energy increases, but nothing else changes. Okay. The charge is not getting transferred to the outside, which means the total mass of the system will not be increased. Will not increase. The total charge of the system remains same, which is true. Getting it? The total charge, which we just learned, the total charge of the system will remain same. The weight of each charge remains same. Is this correct? Can someone tell me if the weight of each charge will remain same? Yes. So why it's a little slow here? I am unable to receive your response yet, and this is a fairly easy question, so let me explain it. The weight of each charge remains same. No, what is happening is one negative charge. Hey, Saket is coming with an S. So this is negative charge. It has more electrons. This has positive charge which has less electrons. Now when both of them are connected, this is positive charge means less electrons. What will happen is excess electrons will go here. Right. Which means the negative charge with negative charge body, which is now turning positive. If you observe, it is turning positive. What does this mean? That this negative charge is entire, whatever extra were there, they left off to the other side. Which means this negative charge will lose weight. Getting it? The negative charge will lose weight and the positive charge will gain weight because positive charge is taking all the electrons. The weight of each charge remains same is wrong. Getting it? But the total mass of the system remains same is correct. This is the basic funda. Getting it? Are you able to understand? Each body, each of the charge, its weight will change because electrons are transferring. But the total will remain same. If suppose, let's take the mass of each electron to be some k. Okay. Let's take mass of each electron to be me. Okay. So, and suppose n electrons moved from here to here. Initially, the mass was m here. So, what is the final mass of the negative charge body? Mass of negative charge body will be m minus n into me. And similarly, this body which has m dash initially, now final weight will be m dash plus n into me. Getting it? So, this is the actual charge happening. Clear? No, everyone? Saket, come on. Got it. So, this is second part of the comprehension. This is a comprehensive type question. So, we have more options here, this thing. This is multiple choice again. So, minus 1 and 5 coulombs are placed in isolated charge. No external charges added to the system. Which of the following combinations is or are possible for the two charges? Now, this one I want you guys to answer. Be quick. I'll give you 1 minute. Basically, I'll give more than 1 minute because there is a little delay for you to see the video. Hi, Sairam, Sri Sairam, Sairam. Okay. So, which of the following possible combinations is or is or are possible? This should be multiple, no? So, guys, 1.5 minutes. I'll give you 1.5 minutes to see this and tell me. It's a very easy question. I want you guys to tackle how to solve multiple choice problems, okay, with confidence. So, just do it quickly. Come on, I thought I gave this question more than 1 minute ago. Huh. So there are no answers here. Unfortunately, you should be doing better. Come on, guys. Okay. I'm still waiting. Come on. Okay, fine. This is... Let me solve it for you now. You guys are taking a little more time. So, we'll solve it now in the next quiz and all. That is why I'm telling you, we'll go to the quiz after this. Stay tuned. We'll go to the quiz after this class. Then we can have live interaction, live discussion. So, that is where it will get very exciting. Okay. Which of the following is possible? Now, initially, this is minus 1 coulomb and 5 coulomb. And we discussed that we can add charges. Getting it? I'm still not solving the answer. Those who are still waiting, just give it away. Answer. So, I am explaining it. Initially, this is minus 1 and this is 5 coulombs. And we discussed charges are scalar. So, how do you calculate total charge? You can just add the numbers. So, total charge should be 4 coulombs, right? The total charge of the system is 4 coulombs and it is staying that much. So, which of the following add up to have 4 coulombs? This is adding up to 3. This is adding up to 4, which is correct. This is adding up to 4 again, which is correct. And this is adding up to 4, which is also correct. So, the answer is B, C, D. Getting it? So, this is one another simple question for your concept checker type. And next for the final question of this this is another question. Okay. If two charges minus 1 and 5 coulomb placed in isolated box, same thing. Now, if an extra charge here, what he is doing is he is bringing in an extra charge here was added to the system such that all the three charges were 4 coulombs at the end. At the end, all the three of them are 4 coulombs. If you observe, he's saying another charge was added to the system. Now, all the three together eventually have 4 coulombs each. Now, the system is a combination of these two charges and the third charge. Understood? Now, the system is combination of charge 1 plus Q2 plus Q3. These three are isolated now. Because the moment Q1 and Q2 are connected to a third charge, these three will become a system now. Understanding? So, now the total charge on this will be 4 coulombs each, means 4 coulombs into 3, which is 12 coulombs. So, each one of them is having how much? 4 coulombs each. So, what is the total now? Minus 1 plus 5 coulombs plus x will be equal to 12. From this, we will get x is 8 coulombs. Getting it? So this is the solution. 8 is the answer from this. Okay. So now continuation of basic properties of charges. This is about all the properties which we know. Now about motion of charges. Okay. This is more than property. This is the most what happens in motion of charge. Okay. So this particular topic we are dealing right now is called electrostatics for a reason. Because the charge is at rest. Electrostatics. The word itself says this is charge at rest. Electrostatic. So this is the basic. Okay, charge at rest will produce only electric field. This is the next topic we are going to discuss after after reading about charges. So charge at rest will produce electric fields. Charge in velocity will produce electric field and magnetic field. Getting it? So charge which is moving with constant velocity will produce both electric field and magnetic field. Electric field along all directions from the charge, it will radiate in all directions. Magnetic will be perpendicular to the velocity. Perpendicular to velocity. Getting it? Magnetic field will be perpendicular to velocity. So this is a very crazy concept. How both of them are linked, we'll know after this topic, which happens in magnetism. It's a very interesting topic there, how both of them are mixing with each other. See, I'm telling you, there is balance across everywhere. If you have to understand in a simple trick, there is balance everywhere. Charges only cause both electric field and magnetic field. So if you get electric field right, magnetic field will be a piece of cake. Okay, so focus carefully here. Understand these topics very well. Okay, this is very important for the next further topics. So the entire second year, majority of it will be based on charges. There you go. And accelerating charges produce electric and magnetic fields and also radiate energy. So this is one thing you have to understand. Accelerating charges will also produce a radiate energy. It can not only just go forward producing electromagnetic waves, it will also radiate. We will discuss about these as we go further. But the first topic which is of major importance for us in this Ad Astra first program is that the charges will be at rest. Okay. They produce electric fields. So before we go to the next topic, here is a little about Unacademy. Crack India, IIT JEE with India's largest platform. Yes, Fleming's left-hand rule for the second point. Yes, now before we go, yes. Crack IIT JEE with India's largest platform. Get the plus subscription to access unlimited live and recorded courses from India's best educators. Okay, this is little about Unacademy and their programs, which I'm going to tell you about. Okay, the plus subscription is the standard package which is provided by Unacademy for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 2 years also. So in this, what you get is you will get daily live classes where you get to chat. See, I'm telling you, I am offering a live class after 10:30 at 10:30 today. On the Unacademy app, which you have to install right away. Unacademy app. Okay, Unacademy Learners app is what is the actual name. So you'll have educators and learners, you are a learner. So at this 10:30 class, I'll have a live class in the name of N. Srikanth. You can come there, we'll have a quiz. Okay. You can understand there exactly how interactive things are. Getting it? It is excellent there. Everything is live. So discussions and all will happen. Your doubts can be asked. We can have polls. I'll have polls, lots of polls. Your doubts you can put in questions. We can have discussions there all while the class is going on. Okay, here it is not possible. Next, it has structured course. All the course and all are structured in line with your exam syllabus. Okay, the entire structure, the course will be in line with your syllabus only. Everything will be based on NCERT syllabus, which like this. And then you'll have live tests and quizzes. You will have live quizzes there, which I can conduct to you guys, or you can take them yourself. I keep telling you guys, right, that if you have a quiz every day, you will end up knowing the art of writing an exam, which is exactly what I want you guys to develop by taking live quizzes every day. Okay. Yes. Hi, Srikant sir. Hi, Mallikarjuna Gautam. Very bad student you are. You came very late. Yes. Okay. Next. Unlimited access. One subscription gets you access to all live and recorded sessions from all teachers who are teaching you JEE. Okay, that is pretty cool. So about the subscription, this is especially for 2021 guys whom I'm actually teaching right now. A few of you, at least. Yeah, it's okay, Gautam. So a few of you guys, like Gautam, who is attempting 2021 exam, this is a 12-month subscription which you have to go for. Okay, now the cost of 12-month subscription is 38,500, but use this awesome code NSS1. It's awesome. Okay, NSS. Use this, you'll get extra 10%. This is my help to you guys. I know in these tough times you need to have you need to take some monetary help, and I'm there to help you. Use this code, you will get it for 34,650 a month. Now you might think for a year, for 12 months. 34,650 is for 12 months. Now you might think this number is big, but let me break it down to you on a daily basis. For those who are aspiring, you have to do work daily, no? So this comes out to 2,888 rupees per month or 96 rupees per day. 98 rupees per day, you are finding it to be okay. 98 rupees one movie theater ticket and all. Let me break it down further. It is 32 rupees for physics, chemistry, and maths. You're getting all three together. So that is where you can things become very small. It's like a lace packet. 32 rupees, you get all three chapters every day, all three subjects every day you can get, or using this NSS1 code that will give you it for 32 rupees. And similarly, if you are doing it for 2022, multiple classes at the same time in your channel. You want to multiple classes at the same time in your channel. Achha. So okay, Sim24, I'll talk about it. I generally take the slot of 10 to 12, right? So I was given this slot today. I think there is some technical issue. We will sort it out. Yes, thank you for the comment, Mallikarjun, Gautam, Yamuna. 32 is crazy, no? So go for it. I am telling everyone, go for this this thing. And those who are writing for 2022, it's even cheaper. It will come out for 50,400. Use this code NSS1. You will get here. You will get it for 23 rupees. There 32 here, 23. So just go for it. Not only this, especially during this time of Corona, Unacademy has launched a new course called Iconic Subscription. Okay, this is a long-term subscription, especially for those students who need teachers beside them. Okay, who need someone to guide them. I know a lot of you are missing teachers. I know a lot of you are missing me also. So Iconic subscriptions are those kind of students who need someone to help them or guide them. They'll be given a personal coach. You'll get one guidance from top experts, like all the teachers will be assigned to you, and you can get guidance from them. They'll be your personal coach, and they'll develop a strategy for you, saying your performance in subjects. They'll analyze your performance and they'll tell you what to work on. Because I know it's tough. A lot of you keep solving problems which you like. You won't do problems which you don't like. You'll try to avoid them. Okay, that is how generally nature of a person is. But those kind of students, if you want to really work on all your weaknesses also, the personal coach will help you. Not only this, you'll get test analysis. Not only the unlimited tests you get, you also get detailed analysis of where you're going slow and where you're going fast. Like some topics you'll do fast and you're doing mistakes. Some topics you're doing slow and you're doing correct. So these kind of analysis of yourself, which you generally don't feel like. In some problems, you take a lot of time, 8 questions in 1 hour, but all 8 are correct. You feel you're not good at this because you're slow, but actually, I don't know. I might be a personal coach. Why not? Get the Iconic subscription and use the code and get this. I think I'll be your coach. Okay. Yeah, I'll work on it. So you do your work. I'm going to get it done. So yeah, one thing I wanted to explain, want you to understand that this test analysis will be given to you, which will help you understand where you're actually good and actually not. And based on these three are mutually related. There'll be a cycle loop going through all these three, where the personal coach will understand your test analysis and give you a study planner, which will be iterated by the personal coach. Not only this, you'll get all benefits of Plus also. Okay, and for this, it's a little expensive. Iconic, of course, because you have a guide for you who is going to help you all the way. But this is not available for 6 months, because if you're getting a guide, you have to have a continuous loop, feedback loop happening for 12 months. So especially for 2021, guys, if you need a teacher's help, go for this. There are no cost EMIs also available for 6 months and above, which is 12 months here. The cost of this is 50,400 if you use the code. So otherwise, it's 56. That's 50,400 per month, which is coming out to 47 rupees per physics, chemistry, and maths with a teacher. With a teacher who's giving you continuous output about how your performance is going. So that should be crazy. Okay. And similarly, for 2 years, it is a little cheaper compared to this. It's a cheaper alternative. It's coming out to 77,400 after using this code NSS1. So go for it, guys. Now, the next topic. One, we have understood about the charges. We know that they are repelling, the like charges repel each other. Unlike charges attract each other. And generally how it works also, we have a brief idea about electrons, how transfer is happening between places. But we know there are forces, right? Like, you know, positive charge and positive charge attract each other. Positive, positive repel each other. Negative, positive attract each other. But with what magnitude? With what magnitude? You need some values, no? Otherwise, how do you solve problems? Especially for JE, you are here to do quantitative analysis of physics for competitive exams. You are doing quantitative analysis, okay? Quantitative means numerical analysis will be what you will do majorly. Okay, theory questions will be there, but IIT JE, most of the problems will have numerical problems or numericals involved. Or anything with numbers only. Thinking in numbers. So, for the amount of force which is caused due to this charge, it should have certain numbers. So, that is what is defined by Coulomb's law. Coulomb only came up with this formula after doing extensive research using the Cavendish experiment. There's a very huge experiment there, the CRT book. We'll go through it when in the additional classes. Okay, so Coulomb's law states that force acting on a body will be proportional to the force acting on a charge will be proportional to the product of both charges. Product of both charges, which means when both charges are one is less and one is more, also the force will be more, and it's similar to gravity. Basically, it will be proportional to the product of both the charges. This has been experimentally proven. Okay, they have used experiments to check this out, and force is also proportional to inverse of the separation square of separation. Okay, it is also proportional to square of separation. So from these both, we will get force will be proportional to Q1, Q2 by D square, where Q1, Q2 are the two charges which are present. Okay. So let me explain this. One charge plus Q1 here and one charge plus Q2 here. They both will experience opposite direction forces. Okay. By logic, we can say both of them will be equal because they are internally pushing each other. No, their system is pushing each other outside, which means the force will be internal. One thing we know by logic is they are equal and opposite. Okay, and the amount of force acting, the force will act along this line, no? It will be opposite directions. What is the meaning of opposite? It can move this direction also, it can move this direction also, but this direction it won't move because whatever direction the line is there between both of them, in that direction only the forces will also be acting. And they will be exactly repelling in nature. The force will be proportional to product of their charges and square of the distance between them. Getting it? So from these both only we will get the value of force is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 Q2 by, I am writing, if you observe carefully guys, force is a vector, but here I am not giving arrows because this here is a scalar. So I am finding the magnitude. This is the magnitude of, getting it? So this is the magnitude of force. It is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q1 Q2 by. So this is the little more elegant display of the given situation. Electrostatic force of interaction between two static points is directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So what is it? Same gravity formula. Exactly. Very one. This is synonymous to gravitational formula. You have to understand this is synonymous to gravitation. Okay. But the only difference is gravitational force is a very weak force. If you remember, gravitational force is weak force, and nuclear and electrostatic forces, electric forces and nuclear forces are strong forces. Getting it? So for this, let's do a small problem. Okay. How to differentiate between forces of charges? Okay. Before we go there, we'll do a small problem. So 1 kg mass and 1 coulomb charge. Okay. 1 kg mass and 1 coulomb charge. We'll find the force between them. Before that, let's finish this. The square distance between them and acts along the line. If the two points are Q1, Q2 separated by distance r, F1, Fb, the electrostatic forces between the two charges according to Coulomb's law. So this is force of charge. This is charge 2, right? This is force due to charge 1 on 2. And here the force will be due to 2 on 1. Getting it? On every charge, there will be force due to other charges, the opposite charge. So force on 1 will be due to 2 and force on 2 will be due to 1. Getting it? If they are positive charge, they will be going away. This is all you have to understand. If they are positive, you can imagine the diagram and imagine both of them are going outside. Okay, no need to take the vector formula, but we'll take the vector formula also, but that is not required for many problem solving. Getting it? For many problems, you can just analyze it by using the diagram here. Understanding? So we know the force is proportional to the product, dono ka product, charge of product of both the charges, and proportional to 1 by r square. The value of force will be equal to kq1 q2 by r square. What is this k? This is the natural proportionality constant. This is called Coulomb's constant or electrostatic constant. Getting it? This is called Coulomb's constant or electrostatic force constant. It is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton meter square by Coulomb square. So such a huge value. What is the value of G we got? 6.67 into 10 to the power minus 11, no? Newton meter square per kg square, remember. Instead of kgs, we got coulombs here. And instead of that huge value, we're getting small value. So what is the ratio of forces? For same or same, it will be this by this. A huge value, we'll find that out right away. But what is the value of k? It is 9 into 10 to the power 9. We'll look about more into this epsilon naught on 1 by 4 pi in dielectrics, because this is a very important question which came in JE this year. Okay. This is a very important concept which came in JE this year. So we will discuss separately about that in the next topic, which I already mentioned in the options. So watch out for that. Now let's take a small example. Okay, keep what is stronger and how it is stronger. Let's take 1 kg and 1 coulomb. Okay, both are separated by 1 meter each. Getting it? So what will be the ratio of force of gravity? Force of gravity will make it force of charge. Force due to charge by force due to gravity will be how much? M is same, 1 meter each, and distance is same, 1 meter. So it will be equal, force due to charge will be K into Q1 into Q2 by 1 square by G into 1 into 1 by 1 square, which is K by G. Just substitute the value, so you will get the value direct, 9 into 10 power 9 by 0.67 into 10 to the power minus 11. This is coming out to be how much? Just, this is crazy, guys. 1.35 into 10 to the power 20. This is the number of times 1 coulomb can cause more force than 1 kg. Getting it? This is why when there is charge on a body, it won't, there is different charge totally overtakes the gravity. Gravitational force only acts across neutral bodies. Getting it? Gravitation only acts across neutral bodies. Gravitation will dominate neutral bodies like sun, earth, everything which is neutral in itself. They'll attract each other like crazy. But coulombs, the moment sun becomes like even 1% of its mass, it has charge. 1% of the mass of the body of sun, if it has charge, then the universe, the sun would, the earth would have raised off somewhere, because there will be so much repulsion. Getting it? So that is the main thing you have to understand, that the electric forces are much stronger than gravitational forces. And the value of it is given by kq1 q2 by r square. But the value is kq1 q2 by r square. Now how does the factors between them affect the charges? Okay, how does the factors change the force between them? We'll analyze Coulomb's law now. Force into Coulomb's law is k into q1 q2 by r square. Now one thing you know here, if q1 is increasing and q2 is stable, what will happen? The force will increase. We'll do different scenarios. We'll just find out how the force is getting affected by different case scenarios. Okay. Then Q1 is same, Q2 is in, both are increasing, it will increase. If both are decreasing, the product, then force will also decrease. Getting it? The force will also decrease. Suppose Q1 is increasing and Q2 is decreasing, what will happen? In this case, we don't know. No, we have to only understand about the product of Q1, Q2. Getting this point? This is the main thing you have to understand. When one of the charges is increasing, other is decreasing, or something like this happens, you don't know how the product varies. It all depends on the product of two charges. We cannot determine. Getting it? Yeah, all thing we have to know is that the product should be Product should change. And in that day, that basis only field will change. Suppose the product becomes 2 times, the force also will become 2 times. Similarly, what happens if the distance increases? The force will decrease in square times that too. Square effort. Effort will become squared. You're getting it? Same gravity formula everywhere, Sim24, it's exactly like that. So you are able to understand, right, that when charges are increasing, like in this, charges are decreasing and radius is increasing. Suppose charges are same and the separation between them is increasing. That then what happens is that the force will decrease at a much faster rate because it is square of radius. It is proportional to 1 by r square. Getting it? So ye logic yaad rakh lo, as r increases, force decreases. As q1, q2 increases, force will increase. So based on these both, we can solve many kinds of problems. It's very similar to gravitational formula. So let's go for some problems like this. Two charges experience a force of F newtons at a separation of D meters. The separation when the force becomes F by 4 newtons. So two charges, the values of charges are not changing. Okay. So the separation when the force becomes F by 4 newtons is, I'm going to give you 1 minute to solve this. Think about it. It's a very simple question. Guys, it's a very simple question, but this is a something you have to understand by logic. Okay. Solve this. I'm giving you 1 minute time. Yes, guys. On, Gautam, I need some answer, man. Mallikarjun Gautam. Yes, correct. Sim24 got it this time. I was expecting Mallikarjun Gautam to do it. Okay. Okay, next, two charges experience a force. If ab dekho, you got it right. Anyone else getting any answer? I guess not. It's okay. The separation when the force becomes F by 4. Simple, no? Force is proportional to 1 by r square. So in these kind of questions, I have a nice trick for you guys. Okay. All ratio questions, remember I'm telling you, lot of questions in IIT JEE will all be ratio based. So you have to understand how those ratios behave. From this you can say F into R square will be constant. Anytime you have something inversely proportional and all, simply you can say it like the product of those both will be constant. Like at constant temperature, P is proportional to 1 by V. Simply we'll say PV is constant. Right. Similarly, F is proportional to 1 by R square, which implies F into R square is constant. This way is a much simpler, like it's a more foolproof way. You can tuck-a-tuck do the answer. Don't do tuck-a-tuck, just do the answer tuck-a-tuck. Okay. So what is the value now? Initially, force is F and distance is D square. Will be equal to now F by 4 into D dash square. So D dash square will be equal to 4D square. D dash is equal to, that's it. Over. Good one, Sim24. You're getting it right? It's a simple question. These are all basics, so I'm going very slow here. Now for the next question. Two charges separated by same distance will experience maximum force. Which of the two charges here? So now the distance is same. What is the force now? Will be KQ1 Q2 by R square. I'm giving 1 more minute for you guys to think about this. Come on, Sim24. I need more answers, quick answers. Tuck-a-tuck. Hi Aditya, long time. How are you? Yeah, full J24. J2 is here, man. Good guys. Very good to see you all. Nice. So this is the new course I'm launching, Aditya. I want you guys to answer this question. Okay, in the meantime, just answer this. I'll be telling you about this course. I've started a new course called Ad Astra. It is, the meaning of it is reach for the skies. Reach for the sky. So I want you guys to reach for the sky and crack JEE along with it. Yes, B is the correct answer. Good one again, Sim24. Great job. So this is the new program I'm launching today. This is the first class. So I want you guys to come here every day. Okay. Either from 8 to 10 or 10 to 12, I'll fix the time. Generally it was 10 to 12 for a long time. I've today shifted it to 8 to 10. I want to see how the response is, which is pretty good. I'm very excited by the way you guys are responding here. So I want you guys to be here, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon on my class. I'm going to give one class every day, okay, of 1 to 2 hours, depends on the day and the problems we are planning that day and all. And we'll have special problems class every day in the app, okay. So, yes, let's go for this question. We know that force will be proportional to product of charges. Remember, as we discussed, the product of both the charges should be maximum. It is not about which one has maximum charge. Like here the sum is 11, but the product is 10 coulomb square. Here the sum is 11 only, but the product is 30 coulomb square. Here sum is 12, it's more than the above, but the product is 27 coulomb square, and here the product is 28 coulomb square, despite of the charges being 16 coulombs. Bapre. The total charge is 16 coulombs of both of them, but still the force is lesser than here, because you have to understand that force is proportional to product of both of them. That's all I want to say. It's a very straightforward thing. Aditya, how are you doing? So I want all of you guys to keep answering quickly. Okay. This is another example question I want you guys. It's a very trick. It's an easy question. Trick question. I want you guys to answer this now. What happens when the force between two charges, when each of the charges doubled, each of their charges doubled, and the separation between them is also doubled? Now, one thing you know, when charge is doubling, force will double, single charge. And when separation is doubling, you know the force will become 1/4 time from the previous question. So think about it and tell me the answer. Suppose the force is F initially. Now it will be some NF, let's say. What is the value of N? Let's make it an integer question. Find the value of N. I'm giving you 1 minute, guys. So the time is, it's almost, sorry. Some technical issue which just happened. Lost all this. One moment, guys. We are almost there. Sim24, before my confusion happened, you got it right. Very good. The answer is 1. Way to go. Aditya, you also, you need to get going, man. We need to be fast now. Okay. When the force between two charges, when each of their charges doubled, the separation between them is also doubled. Okay. So now force will be Q1, Q2 by R square. So force is proportional to Q1, Q2 by R square. So you can also say F into R square by Q1, Q2 will be constant. So all these you can just do off like this only. No need to even take anything. F into R into Q1, Q2 will be constant. So initially we'll call it F into R square by Q1, Q2 will be equal to final F dash into 2R whole square into 2Q1 into 2Q2. Now just cancel off all Q1, Q2, Q1, Q2, R square gone. We're left with F is equal to F dash into 2 square by 4, which is F. F dash, from this directly we will get F dash is equal to 1F plus N is 1. Got it? So this is how simple. Okay, internet connectivity issue. No problem, man. Install the app. Okay, before we go any further, let's finish this first, then I'll tell you about the app. In vector form. Okay, now we'll talk about in vector form. Though I told you it's not required, whenever you have any sort of confusion, you can just go back to vector form, because generally, if you are good at vectors, you can, any doubt you have, you can just go rely on vectors. Those who are not good at vectors, is those guys are having a problem with remembering formulas and all. Okay, because directions, if you are confused, you can visualize only so much. But in vector form, it's like proper mathematical technique. Okay, so that is why I want you guys to understand vectors. I'll also explain this based on this given formulas. Okay, F12 is force on 1 due to 2. Force on 1 given by 2. Force on 1 given by 2 will be in this direction, no, backward. So what is the direction of the position vector we'll write? It is starting from 2 and ending at 1. No? So we'll call this R21 vector, right? So direction of force, force on 1 due to 2 will be in the direction of 1 from 2. Force on 1 will be caused due to the position vector 2, 1 from 2. So the force is acting from here like this force will act. Okay, the best way to understand for you is, suppose there are two positive charges. R21 anyway. This is R12, this is R21. Suppose there's charges here and here. On this, the force will act because of this side, it's pushing this side. No? Now, on this, the charge on force on Q1 will be because Q2 is pushing it to the other side. Q2 is pushing it. So the line will be, where will the line start? Because Q2 is only pushing it, the line will start at Q2. Getting it? Now, if two charges are there, both are repelling each other. Who is pushing this charge? So from which, where will this force start? From here, the force is starting and it will push it in this direction. That is the simple way to understand it. Got it? Every force you take it as repulsive only for now. Because if Q1 and Q2 values are negative, automatically the directions will change. If either of Q1 and Q2 are negative, if either of Q1 and Q2 are negative, what will happen? Automatically, this whole thing will become negative. And negative of a vector means direction is flipped. It's 180 degrees. So there is no issue there. I want you guys to understand the force will always start, force due to a charge will always start at the charge itself. Just like gravitational force will start inside. Your energy will be inside you first before you send it outside. Same way, the force due to a charge will also be inside of the charge. It is pushing it now. Getting it. So it starts from the charge and ends at the charge which is getting affected. Ultimately, who is getting the force? The other charge. So that should be the final place. Simple. So that is the best way to understand it, guys. Getting it. Aditya, Newton's laws of motion, crash course. This is majorly for you guys. 2021, definitely we can do crash course on Newton's laws. But this is the new course I just launched. This is the first course I'm launching after the problems. After JEE Advanced, this is the first course I'm launching. So any serious doubts you have, you can keep asking. If there are more students like you coming in with this doubt, I'll definitely take a Newton's laws of motion course. Yeah, there are a lot of tricks there which I can explain. We have tricks everywhere anyway. So yeah, it depends. So I got this request from new students only, like 3-4 of you guys students told me to start second year class, sir. We are waiting for second year and all. So that is why I launched this program for second year guys. Okay. I will go through all of them as fast as possible once the basics are done. Getting it. Yeah, we'll have special classes definitely as we go towards next year's JEE. Before the JEE comes, I will try to cover at least H.C. Verma top 20 problems and Irido special problems. We'll have those for Newton's laws of motion for sure. Okay. Don't worry. Previous IIT questions, so I compulsory cover karunga. In fact, I actually covered it. You can check the channel. But topic wise, I'll cover in the next time. Clear? Okay. We'll have a revision class for sure. But yes, this is the first one. F12 is the force on Q1 due to Q2 will be acting in the direction of R21, which is what is given here. Getting it? So now this is the magnitude, right? So this should be only direction. This is magnitude, which means this is direction. We all know this. I will tell this again. Any vector is a product of magnitude and direction. This is how I see it. Okay. For mathematical calculation, this is the best way of understanding it. Hi, Janaki Garu. Velocity vector is a product of a vector is a product of magnitude and direction. Getting it? The magnitude is value and direction is unit vector. Anything which does not have magnitude but only has direction does not have matlab, unit magnitude is a unit vector. So this is the formula. So you can also write this in another way, saying KQ1 Q2 by R cube into R21 vector. Because this unit vector can be written as vector by magnitude of the vector. This is also another way of writing it. Getting it? This is another useful formula. So this or that, either ways it is totally fine. The force on 2 due to 1 will be in the other way around, exactly opposite to this. Getting it? The force on 2 due to 1 will be KQ1 Q2 by R square into R12. Force on 2 due to 1. It starts at 1 and goes like this. So this vector is R12 vector. By standard mathematical representation, we call it R12. Getting it? So this is how we get. This is the basic formula. Let's take a small example. A particle, I didn't write the example, a particle of charge 1 microcoulomb is placed at origin. This is the question I am writing, guys, just on the go questions. This is one live example, unsolved example. A particle of 1 microcoulomb is placed at origin and then another particle, we'll call this particle P1, particle P. Another particle Q of charge minus 1 microcoulomb is placed at A comma B. Okay, find force on particle P, Q to Q. This is the question, guys. So the main thing I want you to understand is that this is not a theoretical question. So I'm going to solve it right away. I'm not giving you time. This is not a problem. I'm just making an example of it. So let me draw it for you first. A particle P is at the origin and particle Q is at some place A comma B, which means what is this vector now? From here to here, this vector can be called AI cap plus BJ cap, right? This is the vector we know. Now, what is the force on P due to Q? P due to Q will be, it is starting, it will be at P due to Q, which means what is the direction of force? There are two ways of understanding it. Okay, one thing we can understand that it is the force will act from P to Q, no? So direction will act from on P due to Q, which means it will start at Q and end at P. So this is the direction of R cap. So R cap's direction will be, and the force will be K into Q. Q1 is 1 microcoulomb. Okay, we'll just call it Q. Each one has Q coulombs, just to make it a variable problem instead of making it that. So K into Q into minus Q. K into Q into minus Q. So here, this is what I'm saying. By what is the separation between them? The length of this will be based on the Pythagoras theorem. If 0, 0 to A comma B, it will be root over A square plus B square into R QP cap. It is starting from Q and going towards P, no? That is the force. So what you have to understand it is, by taking, since they are positive and negative charges, we can by logic say it is attractive force on both of them. Getting it? By logic, we can say it is an attractive force on both of them. The force on this will be in this direction, the force will be in this direction. You can calculate this R vector and directly solve it. What will this R vector be? AI cap plus BJ cap vector by magnitude of it, which is equal to root A square plus B square. Okay, but RQP cap, on the other hand, RQP cap will be exactly opposite of this, right? Minus AI cap plus BJ cap, right? Root over A square plus B square. So one way you can write is find magnitude and you know direction. Magnitude and direction. You know magnitude will be, magnitude cannot be negative. So magnitude of force will be KQ1 Q2 by R square. In this case, directly it will come out to be KQ square by A square plus B square. Getting it, and you got the direction, you can solve it this way. Another way is by using the vector formula, which I'll use right now because we just solved it. So what do we get? Minus kq square from this only. Minus kq square by a square plus b square into minus ai cap plus bj cap by root over a square plus b square. From this way, getting the value, minus and minus are getting cancelled, we'll get kq square into ai cap plus bj cap by a square plus b square power 3 by 2. Now from the previous method also, if you solve, you will get the same answer. Try it yourself. You will understand that you can either use your logic or use the formula in vector form, but don't confuse between both. Okay. Have clarity of concept or clarity of thought. Clarity of thought is when you use vectors. Clarity of concept is when you can visualize it and solve it yourself by taking, okay, distance is this much, I know force, value, magnitude and direction, R vector, I know it is attracting, so this will be that direction. If you know the concepts, you can remember this, or technically you have to just apply the formula, you'll get the. Got it? So these are the final properties of Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law is similar to Newton's law of gravitation in many ways. In many possible ways, they are similar to law of gravitation. One thing is, but there are some differences. Like we just discussed, force of gravity is gm1 m2 by r square, right? And force of Coulomb's law of electrostatics will be kq1 q2 by R square. They are very similar in a lot of senses. Little differences are there which we already observed, but then this is the major. Next, Coulomb's law is similar to Newton's law of gravitation, but these are the differences. And this is general observations, not differences. One thing is, electrostatic force can be both attractive and repulsive. This is how it separates from Coulomb's law. Okay. Coulomb's law, this is how it separates from Newton's law of gravitation. Newton's law of gravitation is only attractive. Okay. But Coulomb's law can be both attractive and repulsive. Like charges, repulsive. Unlike charges, attractive. That's simple. You know that already. The force acts as an action-reaction pair. Okay. So, one force is acting here. Then the other force will be equivalent and opposite. Force 1, force 2. Suppose these both are charges. So, F1 will be equal to minus F2. And they act at the same time also. It's not even action-reaction pair will happen at the same time. Don't. Always there is one major confusion for you guys. Action-reaction means one guy will do action, then the other guy will do reaction. You think that is how it is. No? It is not like that. Action reaction happens simultaneously. That's happening at same time. Okay, this is the major thing. It's basic. I know a lot of you know it. And they are acting in the opposite direction. So we can also say F1 vector action reaction pair will always add up to become. Okay, it is central by nature, which means wherever charge is placed, that is where it will. From charge to charge, it's not like a big body is there, matlab the whole thing will change. It's not like that. Everything will be based on charge to charge. We'll do some theoretical question on this, which is very interesting. You'll understand better. The force is conservative in nature, which means if it is conservative in nature, you know, gravitational force is conservative, right? Similarly, even this force is conservative in nature, which means we can define potential energy. This is going to help us a lot in solving problems. This is only this gravity, the electric potential energy is only called potential difference. Okay. V, that V we solve in that V is equal to IR wala V. This V is nothing but potential difference, guys. Lot of exciting things to come. Okay, we'll discuss about potential difference. Before that, we have to discuss field also. We understood that force is conservative, so energy can be defined by using this force. Okay. So This is the main thing I want you guys to understand. We will we are done with the 2 hours for today. We will continue with this class tomorrow from 10 from 10 or 9, whatever. I'll send it on my YouTube. It will be available to you if you hit the bell icon. Okay, press the bell icon for this class, for this channel. And I want you guys to come again. We'll have loads of fun, lots of questions coming, guys. Lots of questions. Once this becomes numerical, I am going to bombard you with questions. Not only this, we have another special class in Unacademy app. Okay. We have a special class in Unacademy app. Not only this, we have a special class in Unacademy app. We have a special class. Okay, we have a special class, guys. I want all of you guys to log in there in half an hour, have your dinner and come there. Special class. I want all of you guys to install the Unacademy app. Okay. This is how the app will look. Okay, install this app. This is how the Unacademy Learners app. Okay, install this app and search for the name N. Srikant. I want you all guys to follow me. I'm fairly new there, so I don't have any followers. All of you guys go there, install the app and follow me there. We will have a quiz at 10:30 there. We are having a quiz at 10:30 based on the topics we did today. Okay, we'll have a quiz mostly based on charges, Coulomb's law. Okay, we'll have questions on Coulomb's law. So let's have a session there. Waiting for you guys. Can't wait to meet you guys there. And for today, this is it. Okay. We will continue tomorrow with the superposition principle. Tomorrow, we'll start off with superposition principle, where it's basically nothing but when multiple charges are there, the total sum of all charges will be equal. We will go there in the next class. And thank you all for being with me. I wish to continue more, but then we have another class there. So let's call it off for today. 10 guys. Okay. So tomorrow at the same time, don't forget, come tomorrow at the same time. Okay. Found in Facebook. Yeah, I'm not using Facebook these days much. So, but yeah, definitely I will try to respond to you guys in all possible media, social media. And that's all for now, guys. So see you with the app. Okay. Install the app right away. We'll have a quiz in exactly half an hour. See you there. Okay. Adios, amigo.